What is hygiene theater? And is it important that we disinfect touch points? Let's take a look at it. So what is hygiene theater and how do we avoid that? Hygiene theater is exactly what it sounds like. It's acting as if we are cleaning surfaces, we are providing a safe place for those that are in facilities or in the public so that they will go out and do what they're supposed to do or do what they want to do, and that could be going to the office or that could be going to the grocery store. And those things show up because a lot of times folks who are out disinfecting surfaces or creating some sort of theater of safety are not educated. They don't know how to use the disinfectants that they've been given, and they don't know how long those disinfectants should sit. They don't know what methods they can use. And we've referred to these items in videos, previous videos. It's very important you go back and look at that. So is hygiene theater real? The simple answer is yes, it is. And is there a way around that? Responsibly speaking, the only way to avoid hygiene theater is to train staff on how to properly disinfect areas, surfaces. So let's talk about high touch point disinfection. Do you have to disinfect every single surface in every area, every facility? The simple answer is no. The only time that that would be important is if you know that you've had a positive COVID case in a facility. Then you need to take every precaution possible to mitigate the risk of the spread of COVID-19. And that's where you would utilize systems like electrostatic disinfection and full terminal cleaning of facilities. But if you're only looking to mitigate the risk of transmission of COVID-19 from people who may be asymptomatic or from folks who may be symptomatic but have to go to the grocery store, you're going to have to use high touch disinfection as a tool. And those high touch points, just to keep it simple, in your pocket, you have a high touch point, which would be your phone. You should be disinfecting your phone every single day, utilizing a wipe and following the instructions on that wipe container. Also, door handles at your home, as well as in your car, door handles, as well as your steering wheel and any other items that you might be touching. When you move into your office environment, you have to use some sort of checklist to disinfect your own personal workspace. And as the CDC recommends, do not share telephones or computers. Always use your own and never let anybody else use it. That's not always something you can do in office environments, and so you're going to have to look at other high-touch areas such as restrooms and shared workplaces like fax machine and other co-workspace areas in buildings. Those need to be disinfected every 3 hours. And that would be lobbies, it'd be restrooms, it would be these other, you know, shared workspaces. If you're not doing that, the chances of passing that virus on to other folks throughout a building, it's real. And it's something that you have to be responsible for. So I hope that answers your questions related to hygiene theater. What is that? As well as, is disinfection necessary and what areas do we need to be disinfecting? Again, please go back, watch those other videos. It's going to really help you out with what is the effective way to disinfect. We're going to be working in this series on future videos related to safety with masks, gloves, so PPE, as well as hand hygiene. So we look forward to having you come back. Until then, have a great day.